Good morning from Montrose Old and St Andrew's Church, and welcome to our short thought for the day. A very happy new year to you. Possibly you're not quite ready to take down the Christmas tree and decorations, or even the Christmas cards you received. There's always something a little plain and dull when you do that. And yet we can't hold on to Christmas forever. Or can we? Things have been tough for us all, and particularly so for some, that it's hardly surprising that we'd like to pull down the curtain on the old year, with, for many, its associations with negativity, illness, loss, challenge, restrictions, and a great deal of uncertainty. If we're being totally honest, what we'd really like is for COVID to go away, but that isn't going to happen. So we have to make the best of it, however hard it might be. And we'll get on better with that, not by putting a brave face on things, but by shaping ourselves for the challenges. One of the ways that we might tackle that is by taking Christmas, or more accurately, the blessings of Christmas, into the new year. A new year offers us the opportunity to start afresh, to make new plans, to set different goals, and to seek to carve out a better life, possibly not just for 2022, but going forward. And yet, we know that New Year resolutions often fail by the end of the first week, and the best intentions to develop good habits can often come to very little before very long. Often that's because we rely too much on managing by ourselves, when what we really need is coaching, encouragement, and doing it together with others. And it's no different when it comes to faith. We aren't put right with God through our best efforts. He sorts things out for us as a gift. We won't carve out a happy and contented life by our grit and determination. It'll only happen as we open ourselves to God's blessing, his gifts of love, forgiveness, and new life, in step with him. But God's gift to the world of his love in the form of his Son wasn't a flash in the pan. The blessing of Christmas didn't fizzle out when the angels went back into heaven, the shepherds went back to their flocks, and the wise men returned home. Nor do the blessings of Christmas, the joy to the world at the birth of the Saviour of the world at Bethlehem, disappear when we go into a new year, or when we take down the decorations, or when we stop singing Christmas carols. For that child so dear and gentle is our Lord in heaven above. Jesus is still Emmanuel, God with us, now, here in Montrose, or wherever we live in 2022. He assures us that he will be with us always, whatever life's challenges, no matter what the future holds for us. And so we can go into this new year with hope, not because everything will turn out well with no issues, but because we know the unshakable love of God in Christ. Thanks for joining us. A very happy new year to you. May you know the abiding presence of God's love in Jesus each and every day of your life. May the Lord bless you. Amen.